The GLSL language is sort of like the C language, which is kind of like JavaScript anyway, but simpler. Because vectors are so important in graphics, the language also has vector support built in. This vertex shader computes the diffuse Lambertian lighting component at each vertex. At the top, you can see the material color defined as a uniform, as something the vertex shader uses as an input. Similarly, the light's direction is passed in as a uniform. Vec3 means a three-element vector, RGB for the color, XYZ for the light's direction. Next is a varying color, vColor, which is an output color. We'll use this in the fragment shader. The vertex shader is required to always output GLPosition, which is a predefined variable. This vector holds the clipping coordinates of the vertex location on the screen. This next line normalizes the direction to the light. This operation is done here more for convenience of the designer, so that the light direction does not have to be passed in normalized. You could get rid of this line if you required that the light direction must be normalized before being passed into this shader. The diffuse reflection model is computed on this next line. We take the dot product of the vertex normal and the light. We use the maximum function here to make sure the result is not negative. A negative number happens when the surface is pointing away from the light. We don't allow the light's contribution to be negative. That would be like light sucking energy from the surface. The final line of the program itself computes the output color, called vColor, by multiplying the color by the diffuse contribution. The shader language is a lot like C or JavaScript, but has some nice built-in features. Here we're multiplying a vector, the material color, times a single value. The language knows to multiply each value of the color vector by the diffuse value.